Are you somebody who cannot work on an untidy desk? If the laptop on your table or a photo on the shelf is not in the right spot, does it bother you? Then this video is for you. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Siddharth Warrier. I'm a neurologist and today I have come on the Big Basket channel to talk about neuroscience and everything that can help you live your life better. In a previous video, we've already talked about how clutter affects your brain. So if you haven't seen that, go watch that later. But today we are talking about why your brain likes order. See, our brain values predictability. When you know where something is, it makes it easier for the brain to plan around that thing. And that means there is less cognitive effort required, which is why we get so attached to having things in a particular place. But why do different people have different levels of cleanliness? See, this is where it gets interesting because the value that our brain attaches to different objects differ. So for example, for me, this hourglass being here might be very important because I attach more value to this. But for somebody else, it doesn't really matter where this is. Which is why in a lot of households, you might see that the husband and wife are arguing about different levels of cleanliness. So the wife might value, say, her kitchen knives being in place or her purse being in a particular spot. And the husband might not value those things, but he would get upset if the TV remote is not where he left it or his car keys are missing. This shows how different people form a mental map of their environment, of the things that are important to them, which is why it leads to so many arguments between people on different levels of cleanliness. Because when the items that are important to you are not in their place, that can lead to discomfort and you want to fix that. And this value system is not just about us, because when we are living in a shared space, for there to be harmony, we need to know and respect what somebody else's value system is as well. And that is how cleanliness as a team can be achieved. Let me know if these kind of arguments happen in your household. Another important aspect of cleanliness is hoarding. Have you ever wondered why it is so hard to let go of things even if they have outlived their purpose? The reason is that our brain evolved at a time when there was scarcity, when we did not have enough access to any resources, whether it's food or information. But today, we are not living in those times. In fact, we are living in a time of abundance. But our brain has still not figured out that it is okay to let go of things, that we don't need to keep holding on to everything. Our current challenge is to recognize this act of hoarding and to fight against that instinct. Our modern level of privilege allows us to not hoard anymore, and it is up to us to have the courage to say no to unnecessary things. Just by preventing the act of hoarding, it makes our cleanliness job incredibly easier. And that brings me to the third neuroscience aspect of cleanliness, which is letting go and gifting. Giving items away is an ancient tradition in India. I remember when growing up, my grandparents would give away clothes, books, so many things from our house. And I've realized that it not only strengthens relationships, but it also reduces attachment to material things. It is a social way of decluttering and it helps people to let go of things without guilt. And in fact, by helping them feel good about giving something away. In today's fast-paced world, this practice can serve us very well. Gifting away things that we don't need anymore, like clothes, books, even gadgets, can be a very useful habit to inculcate, but it is a habit that needs to be worked on, and I don't think it happens very naturally. But believe me, once you start gifting, the positive feedback and the emotional validation you get from it makes it worthwhile. And it also helps you keep your house cleaner. So to wrap up this video, understanding these neuroscience-based tips for cleaning can truly help you live your life better by changing the way you value the arrangement of things in your environment, to actively fighting against hoarding, and by increasing the habit of gifting. It can truly transform the way you keep your house and your workspace clean. Now for the giveaway question. What was the item that I had picked as an example to show how I value certain things on my table? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to the Big Basket channel, and let me know what other neuroscience topics you would like me to cover on this channel. Bye everyone, see you in the next video and happy cleaning.